Well, praise the Lord, everybody. We thank God for Bible study tonight. We give honor to God. Truly, it's a blessing to be in the house of the Lord on tonight. I'm Pastor Kendall Fleetwood, along with my wife, Pastor George Fleetwood, and we are the pastors and founders of Victory Tabernacle Bible Training Center. We give God praise on today because truly God is good to us on tonight. We're getting ready to, before we go into praise and worship, we're going to go in and have a few minutes of prayer. And after prayer, we're going to let my wife and Minister Josh, Minister Juwan, and thank God for Brother Saquon, and they're going to minister to us tonight. One selection, maybe two, but probably one selection on tonight. Hallelujah to God. So you that are by way of Facebook, if you would, just bow your heads and let's go into prayer. Father, we thank you for this day, for truly this is the day that you have made, and we will rejoice and we will be glad in it. Father, we bless your name. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your loving kindness. Father, we thank you today for giving us the victory, for your word said, thanks be unto God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you for being victorious, God. We realize what you did at Calvary and even in your resurrection, that you gave us victory. And Father, we operate from a place of victory. We operate from a foundation of victory. Hallelujah. We're not fighting for victory, but we're going from victory to victory. Father, we thank you for giving us the victory. And Father, we realize that the victory is not through our might. It is not by our own strength, but the victory is through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And your word told us to be steadfast and unmovable because we are operating from a place of victory. Your word told us to be steadfast and to be unmovable and always abounding in the work of the Lord. Help us, God. Help us today to be steadfast. Help us to be unmovable and help us to be always abounding in the work of the Lord, Father. For you said in your word that our labor is not in vain, Lord. Somebody is tired today. Somebody feel like their labor is in vain, Lord. But Father, let them know that their labor is not in vain, Lord. Father, we thank you for being born of you, Lord. You said, Lord God, you said that whosoever is born of God overcometh the world, Lord. Father, we thank you, God, that we are born of you, Lord, and we overcome the world. We overcome the world system and everything that is in it. We overcome poverty. We overcome, Lord, discouragement. We overcome, Lord, whenever the enemy would throw us our way, Father, because we're born of you, that we overcome the world. And you said this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith, Lord. Help us to go forth in the faith of God. Help us, oh God, to go forth, God, trusting in you and trusting in your word, Lord. Father, we thank you for victory today, God. Who shall separate us from the love of God? Father, I thank you for victory over tribulation. Thank you for victory over distress. Thank you, God, for victory over persecution, and victory over famine, and victory over nakedness, and victory over peril, and victory over sword, Lord. Father, we thank you, God, that you made us more than conquerors, but it's through you, God, that loved us. Father, we go forth as more than conquerors, and Father, we conquer everything that comes within our way, Lord. Father, we conquer every enemy, and Father, every trick of the enemy, and hallelujah to God, and whatever, hallelujah to God, whatever evil spirit come our way, Father, we are more than conquerors. Father, I thank you today, for you are the shield for me, Lord. Thank you for being our shield, Lord. Thank you for being my glory, and being the lifter up of my head, Lord. Oh, Shai, God, I bless your name, God. I bless your name, Lord. Father, Father, we thank you, God. Thank you, oh God. Thank you. Help us to know and continue to know that we are of you, God. And because we are of you, God, you told us we overcome them. And you said that greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. Help us to know, God, that we're greater. Father, help us to know, God, that we're greater. We're greater than any serpent. We're greater than any scorpion. We're greater, God, than any, hallelujah, any virus. That we're greater than anything that the enemy can throw our way. Help us to know, God, that we're greater, and help your people to go forth with that spirit of greatness and to operate out of that spirit of greater. Oh God, I praise you. Hallelujah. Holy Ghost, we thank you. We thank you, Holy Ghost. Hallelujah to God. Father, your word said after the Holy Ghost will come upon us, we shall have power. Help us to go forth with that power. Help us to go forth, Lord. Oh Shai, God, in the spirit of power. Help us to go forth, Lord. Father, we thank you, God. We give you praise, Lord. Father, on our prayer today. On our prayer today. Hallelujah. God, I praise you on our prayer today. On our prayer. Father, we praise your name. Hallelujah. Oh, God, we bless you. Father, we praise you. Father, we praise you. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah to God. We're getting ready. Hallelujah to hear. Hallelujah to God from Pastor George. Come on here. Hallelujah to God. Minister Jawan Fleetwood. Minister Joshua Fleetwood. And Brother St. John. Let's give it up for them as they come and minister. Hallelujah to God. A song of praise unto the Lord. And after that, I'm going to come back and I'm going to teach the word of the Lord. But do me a favor. Go ahead and tag somebody in. Go ahead and let them know, hallelujah to God, that Victory Tabernacle is on the air. Let them know how we're getting ready to sing the praises of God, and we're getting ready to go to the word of God. I tell you what, invite a friend. Hallelujah to God. Share. Hallelujah. Post. Give comments. Hallelujah to God.
Praise the Lord to everyone out there. We want to thank you for joining us in worship. We're going to take you back tonight. We're going to sing Emmanuel. Help us sing and lift up the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The name of the song, it means God with us.
Yes,
no
yes.
matter what we're going through, God is with us.
Yes, he is.
He's present. He's a very present help.
Thank you, Father.
Help us sing this song. Sing it with us unto God as we worship.
Thank you, Father.
Come on, lift your hands up there. Help us out.
Worship.
Father God, we thank God for Pastor Joyce and Minister Juwan and Minister Josh, and we thank God for Brother St. Quan, Minister Notes of Music, as they sung the song of the Lord. Truly indeed, God is with us, and God was with them as they were singing the song of tonight. Listen, we're getting ready to go to the word of the Lord, and hallelujah to God, and see what God has to say. We're going to continue on intimacy on tonight. And we're going to try to pick up where we left off on last week concerning intimacy. Let me say this before I go any further. We want to thank God for celebrating 21 years.
Yes.
On Sunday, we celebrated 21-year church anniversary. Yes. And we thank God for what God is doing here at Victory Tabernacle. No way are we tired, discouraged, or anything like that. Is that all right? Hallelujah to God. We're excited about what God is doing. Is that all right?
My God.
God, I praise your name and I give you glory. We're getting ready to go to the word of the Lord. You didn't have Bibles. Turn to Psalms 119 and verse. We're going to read verse 67 through verse 72. Let me say this also by way of announcement. I want to thank God for Victory Tabernacle. I just want to let you know, I want to give a big shout out to you.
Bless God.
And I want to give a shout out to you for being a blessing, even though we're not able to convene, even though we're not able to come together. I want to thank you for continuing to keep the covenant and being a blessing to your church and being a blessing by way of tithe and by way of offerings. And hallelujah to God. I just bless God for you, even though we're not able to be here. But thank God that you are finding the ways that, Pastor, I need to pay my tithes. Pastor, how can I get my tithes to you? And you're just wanting to. You're not trying to run from your responsibility as members. And I just want to tell you thank you. And I just really appreciate, hallelujah to God, the members of Victory Tabernacle. I appreciate you for meeting us 8 o'clock in the morning on Sunday for prayer. And then meeting us 11 o'clock on Sunday and meeting us at 7 o'clock tonight. And I just want to let you know that I thank you and I appreciate you for me and Pastor George. God bless you. Hallelujah. You that have Bibles, turn to Psalms 119, and we're going to read 67 through verse 72. I don't know if I'm going to be able to finish it tonight, but I just want to talk. I just want to talk concerning intimacy, and I just want to go into these five verses, and I just want to, because this is Bible study, I just want to go and break down what I receive out of these five verses. As I was reading Psalms 119 and meditating in Psalms 119, God had me to pull these five verses out. Is that all right? David said, before I was afflicted, I went astray. He said, but now have I kept thy word. Thou art good and doest good. Teach me thy statutes. The proud hath forged a lie against me, but I will keep thy precepts with my whole heart. Their heart is as fat as grease, but I delight in thy law. It is good for me that I have been afflicted, that I may learn thy statutes. The law of thy mouth is better to me than thousands of gold and silver.
My God.
Hallelujah to God. I want to talk to you tonight concerning intimacy, and I want to show you in these five verses nine things that, hallelujah to God, that I got out of these five verses and concerning intimacy. Is that all right? That we've already, because this is our fourth time, I think, we already talked about what intimacy was. We already talked about the Father's desire for intimacy. We already talked about what intimacy was and what intimacy was not. We talked about that intimacy starts with our desire, our thirst, our hunger, and our longing for God. We talked about, how do I get there? How do I find this place called intimacy? We talked about, hallelujah to God, where is my passion? We talked about it. We looked at Bible characters that had passion and some that did not have passion. We gave you examples. We talked about that intimacy causes us to know the counsel of God. Well, tonight, I just want to talk at Psalms 119, the first thing I want you to know, in the first verse, David said, before I was afflicted, I went astray, but now I've kept your word. The first thing I want to really hone in on is David went astray. He said, before the afflictions came, before the humbling came, before, hallelujah to God, the trial, and before the tribulation came, before the thing that caused me to be humble, David said, before it came, the main thing I want you to understand, the first point I want you to make is that David went astray.
My God.
And he said, I went astray. And if you run a reference in the Hebrews, it means he committed sin and he committed error. When you run reference in the Hebrew, it means to commit sin and to commit error. David wandered away from his post. David was following afar off. David, somewhere, he lost his intimacy with God. Hallelujah. He lost his desire for the word. He lost his worship, and he lost, hallelujah, his passion for the ways of God. David said, I went astray. He said, listen, before the affliction came, before the chastisement came that helped me get in line, he said, listen, this is my testimony, and I'm being transparent with you, and I'm being honest with you. David said, I went astray. He said, I committed sin, and I was in error. He said, but listen, he said, but now I've kept thy word. Now keep in mind, the first thing I want you to really get in your spirit, if we're going to learn, if we're going to teach this thing concerning intimacy, is that David admitted that he lost his intimacy with God. He admitted that he strayed away, that he committed sin, he was in an error, and he wandered away from the path that he knew to follow. He wandered away and he followed afar off, and David is telling us here that I've lost my intimacy with God. David is saying, hallelujah to God, come on here. My relationship is not as close as it was. My relationship and my fellowship with him is not as close as it was before. I've been following afar off, hallelujah to God. My love for the word, my love for worship, hallelujah to God, it got slack. I got slack, and hallelujah to God, and my passion was not there like it was in Psalms, the 42nd chapter. My passion was not there like it was in Psalm 63. He said, I've got to be honest with y'all. I went astray.
Yes, yes, yes.
Hallelujah to God. Pastor, why are you emphasizing that? I'm telling you, a lot of us have went astray. Hallelujah to God. Come on here. Our love for God is not where like it used to be. Our passion for God is not where like it used to be. Our desire for the word is not like it used to be. Our desire for praise is not like it used to be. Hallelujah to God. We're not, some of us, we're not able to come to church. And you know what? It don't even matter. Hallelujah to God. So what? I'm not able to come to church. Hallelujah to God. The bottom line is I went astray. Hallelujah to God. But look what David said. He said, but now I've kept thy word. What are you trying to say, Pastor? The second thing you need to write down in your notes, the path to intimacy starts with the keeping of the word. Pastor, how can I get my intimacy back? How can I get that close relationship? How can I get back close to God? Pastor, I want to get back where I was. I want to get back to that close relationship with God. How can I do it? It starts with keeping up the word. He said, listen, I retained the word. I restored the word up like it was food. Hallelujah to God. He said, I guarded it and I protected the word. I watched over the word. I became a watchman. I became careful and attentive to that word. I became careful to keep it like a watchman and like a doorkeeper and like a gatekeeper. Hallelujah to God. How many know that's one of the first steps to getting your intimacy back? Because listen,
I didn't say it. David said, I went astray. He was talking about himself. He said, I went astray. But David said, listen, one of the first keys to getting back to intimacy is the keeping of the word. Hallelujah to God. David began to say, the word is a lamp unto my feet and it's a light unto my path. He said that later on in chapter, this same chapter, he began to talk about the word. And David began to say, hallelujah to God, I know I went astray. He said, but now I'm keeping the word. Hallelujah to God, the word is a lamp unto my feet and it's a light unto my path. Hashiah. He began to say, we know, listen, can I bring some, well, let me stay with the Old Testament. And I'm still talking about David. David said, wherewith shall a young man cleanse his way? By taking heed according to the word of the Lord. David began to say, I watched over the word. I was a doorkeeper of the word. I was a gatekeeper of the word. David said, I made sure that I kept the word. I didn't let God's word slip. I didn't let word God's word. Hallelujah. I kept it in my mind. I kept it in my heart. And I guarded God's word. Hashiah. What are you saying, David? David was trying to tell her, listen, if I didn't know no better, I thought David was in the New Testament when the Bible said, be doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving your own self. Yeah. Sound like to me, David, even though he was in song, he was prophesying and walking out jail. David was saying, I've kept the word. I'm a doer of the word, not a hearer. I'm not deceiving myself. Hallelujah to God. David said, I know how to get my intimacy back. Yeah. It is by the keeping of the word. David said, listen, the Bible said, if any man be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like it to a man beholding his face in the glass. He behold himself and goeth his way and straightway forgetting what manner of man he was. But the Bible said, I believe David was fulfilling James. But whosoever looketh into the perfect law of liberty, watch this, y'all, don't just look into the word, but continue therein. Be not a forgetful here, watch this, y'all, but a doer of the work. Make sure you understand the word comes for you to work it. Hallelujah to God. You got to work the word. The word comes. When the word comes, it comes for you to be a doer of the word. The word comes for you to put in work. The word comes for you to do work. So I got to do work with my attitude. I got to do work with my mindset. I got to do work with my perspective. The word, that's why you got to meditate in the word. I'm doing work. I'm putting in work. Hashiah. And listen, this man shall be blessed in his deed. God, I praise you. Because listen, y'all, I can't just look in the mirror and forget what manner of man I was. But I got to come on here. I got to look into God's perfect law of liberty. And I've got to stay there. And that's why David knew. He understood and he knew, hallelujah to God, that he had to stay in the word. He understood, hallelujah to God, even though I've gone astray. He said, I know how to get it. I know how to come back to God. I know how to repair my relationship with God. I know how to get intimate with God again. He said, listen, the Bible said in the New Testament, if you love me, you will keep my commandment. And David understood, if I get back to keeping the commandment, if I get back to walking in the statute and obeying his ordinances, David understood. How many know intimacy will come back when you be obedient to the word? David said, now, he said, yeah, I went astray. You want the honest truth? Can't lie to y'all. I went astray. He said, but now, he said, I'm keeping the word. I'm a keeper of the word. God, I prayed. The Bible said, grass withered, a flower faded, but the word of our God shall stand. And how many know, hallelujah to God, if I'm going to stand, I've got to stand in the word. That's why David said, the entrance of thy word, it giveth light, and it giveth understanding. understanding unto the simple. David said, do you see the light? David said, I see the light now. I can see the light. And the light is that, come on here, I won't be satisfied until I awake with that light. Then David said, I see the light. And the light is in obeying God's word. The light is being subject and coming, subject and coming in alignment and in agreement to the word of the Lord. David said, come on here, it is the entrance of the word that giveth light, and it giveth understanding even to the simple. Hallelujah to God. How many know you ain't got to be deep? You don't have to have a college of education, but it gives understanding unto the simple. David said, it is the word. The Bible says, so shall my word that goeth forth out of their mouth. And he said, my word shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which it pleaded, and it shall prosper in the thing whereunto I sent it. David said, I'm holding fast to that word. I'm not letting that word go. I'm sleeping with that word. I'm meditating day and night in that word so that I can make sure, hallelujah, that I'm keeping the word, because I understand, hallelujah, there can be no intimacy without the keeping of the word. You tell me you're intimate all day, but if you're not keeping the word, David said, come on here, I went astray. I will admit,
My God.
He said, but now, hallelujah, I'm a keeper of the word. Hallelujah, I guard the word. I guard the word. God, I praise you. That word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against God. It's tucked away. Come on here. The enemy can't take it away. I got it hid in my heart. You got to get to the place of God when you hide the word in your heart. You got to get to the place in God. Come on here. That's how you know you're getting intimate. You're getting close to God when you can hide the word in your heart. And how many know when you hide it in your heart, tell your neighbor, it'll come up when you need it. When you hide the word in your heart, you'll be put in a situation. How many know that word will come up? Yes, sir. You know why? Because it's hid in your heart. And when it's hid in your heart, how many know the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, will bring all things to your remembrance. Hallelujah. Make sure you understand the Holy Ghost can't bring something up if it ain't already there. But if you will hide it in your heart, how many know when you need it, he will pull it up. Oh God, I praise you. I gotta move. The path to intimacy starts with the keeping of the word, the preserving of the word, the retaining of the word, the guarding of the word, the protecting of the word, the watching over of the word. Hallelujah to God. That's why when the word is coming forth, are you in meditation? Are you reading? Are you studying? Hallelujah to God. You've got to make sure you get away from all distraction. You get away, hallelujah to God, from everything that will stop you, hallelujah, from hearing the word of the Lord. I need to hear the instructions from the word of the Lord. You know I want to hear it. I don't want to hear it just to be hollering amen. I don't want to hear it just to jump and shout. I don't want to hear it to be the loudest one in the church. I want to hear it so I can put it into action. I want to hear it because I want to do it. I want to come on here. I want to be a doer of the work, because when I hear the word, how many know it's an assignment? When I hear the word, come on here, it's my walking papers. When I hear the word, it is my assignment. It gives me work to do. Yes, sir. It could be a word about being a better husband. How many know that's work? It could be a word about, hallelujah to God, being a better wife. Tell your neighbor, that's work. It could be a word, hallelujah, about how to finance my money. Tell your neighbor, that's work. When you hear the word, make sure you understand. When you hear the word, it gives you an assignment. It is the word that gives you work. Yes, sir. Hallelujah. To tell your neighbor, I heard the word and I got work to do. None of us have got it made. None of us got it all together. Every time we hear the word, it gives us work.
Yes, it does.
Oh God, I praise you. I can stay there. I'm telling you, I can stay there. Hallelujah to God. Number three. Now, what do I want you to get out tonight? Number one, I want you to get out tonight that David went astray.
Yes.
That what I want you to get out tonight is that the path to intimacy. Well, David, how do you get back? How do you get that intimacy back? Hallelujah. Starts with the keeping of the word.
My God.
Hallelujah. That's number two. Number three, the path to intimacy, watch this, y'all, is to have a right perspective of God. Tell your neighbor, a right perspective of God.
Right perspective of God. God.
Yes, a lot of us, listen, David did not one time did I see David, hallelujah to God, like, be mad at God about his affliction. Not one time did I see, yes, hallelujah to God, that David blamed God for his affliction. He said, before I was afflicted, I went astray. He said, but now I've kept your word. Not one time did he say, hallelujah to God. Not one time did he say, God, you put this affliction on me. Not one time did you say, God, you were wrong.
Yes,
you allowed these afflictions to come on me. Not one time he
said
that. But you know what he said? He said, not only are you good, but you doeth good. You are good. Tell your neighbor, you know you're on the path to intimacy when you have a right perspective of God. Yes, hallelujah to God. You've got to see his character. You've got to see, come on here, tell your neighbor, thou art good. Yes, sir, you've got to see, hallelujah to God, the character, God's character. How many know he's good in nature, and not just good in nature, watch this, y'all, but how many know he's good in action? Not only are you good, but you do as good. Yes, sir, hallelujah, tell your neighbor, he's always doing good. Hallelujah to God. Good in nature. Not only good in nature. How many know he's good in action? David said, listen, when I went astray, I know he's good. How do you know, David? He didn't give up on me. How do you know, David? Hallelujah to God. Was what? When it looks like I should have. David, what can you tell me, David? What's your testimony? When my foot slipped. Mercy, help me. What are you trying to say? Not only is he good, but he's good in action. He's good in nature, and he's good in action. David said, I've got a right perspective of God. I'm not walking around and saying, well, God, let this happen to me. I'm not walking around saying, hallelujah to God. Hallelujah. Why you let this happen to me? Why did it come on me? Hallelujah to God. This is all God's fault. David said, no, sir. He said, I understand. Hallelujah. His nature is good. His actions are good. Hallelujah to God. He said, I've got a right perspective of God. When you get to the place, hallelujah to God, when you've got a right perspective of God, how many know you're getting somewhere? I believe it was David said in Psalms later on, he said, the Lord is good to all, and his tender mercy are over all his work. He said, listen, God is good to everybody. He listened, the New Testament said, he calls it to rain on the just just like he do the unjust. How many of y'all know we serve a good God? Yes, sir. David began to sing in song, deliver me not over to the will of my enemies. He said, false witnesses, they rose up against me and they breathed out cruelty. He said, I watched this, y'all. David said, man, hallelujah to God, man, they was coming at me. Hallelujah. He said, God, don't deliver me to the will of my enemies. He said, all these false witnesses rising up against me and they breathing out cruelty. But watch what David said. He said, I would have fainted, man. I would have lost my mind. I would have threw my hands up. I would have quit unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord, not just in the Bible, but in the land of the living. He said, man, I would have, hallelujah to God. David said, man, I would have been in a pickle. I wouldn't have been in a mess, but I saw the goodness of the Lord.
David said,
listen, my enemies is kicking up dust. False witnesses are rising up against me, and they lying on me on every side. And David said, man, I'm telling y'all, I would have fainted. He said, but you know what? I saw the goodness of the Lord. How many of y'all know? Listen, you know you're getting intimate with God. You're getting in the right place with God when you have a right perspective of God. How do you see he's good in nature? And listen, not just good in nature. Make sure y'all understand. Watch this, y'all. He's good in action because he's good in nature. Listen, y'all. It is his nature, the hallelujah, that causes his action to proceed.
Yeah.
Make sure you understand. He's got no other choice but to be good in action. Hallelujah, because his nature is good.
Yeah.
How many of y'all, ever since we were a child, we said God is good, God is great. They taught us as a baby that God is good.
Yes, yes.
Yes, sir. Hallelujah. How many of y'all know God is good?
Yes, he is.
Yes, sir. When you get that perspective, hallelujah to God, and these things, certain things happen to us, and we say, hallelujah, how do God do this? Why God do this to me? Why did God let these things happen to me? Hallelujah to God. But make sure you understand, you got to still hang in there, because the goodness of the Lord, they, hallelujah, you are still experiencing the goodness of the Lord. Hallelujah to God. And David began to say, man, I would have fainted unless I believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Hallelujah to God. Come on here. He said, listen, I saw God's goodness in action. I didn't just see his goodness in nature. How many know, watch this, y'all. They was trying to teach us as a child concerning the nature of God. That's why they told us God is good. God is good. They wanted y'all to understand about his nature. Yes, but the older I get, I see his goodness in action. I see God at. Hallelujah to God. I see the actions of God. And I see God at. And the Bible said in verse 14, wait on the Lord. He said, man, how many know the goodness of the Lord is coming? I see what David was talking about when he told us to wait. Wait for what? You're going to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Pastor, you don't know what I'm going to. Ain't that working out for me? Pastor, this virus, they got me in the house. I ain't got no job. And things are looking bad, Pastor. But I'm telling you, wait. You're going to see the goodness of the Lord. Hallelujah. Right in the land. Hallelujah. Of the virus. Right during the time of the virus. You're going to see the goodness of the Lord. Yes, sir. Hallelujah. I mean, no, God in action. The goodness of God. God in action.
My God.
And what were we waiting on? Oh God, I praise you. Oh, what were we waiting on? Pastor George, what were we waiting on? He told us to wait on the Lord. What was we waiting on? For the goodness of the Lord. We was waiting for the goodness of the Lord. We were waiting for God to go into action. Things look bad now. But you know what? It's just a matter of time for God to act. Yes, sir. God, it is time for him to go forth. Listen, I'm not discouraged. I'm not feeling bad. I don't understand why these things happen to me, but one thing I do know, the God that is good in nature, he's going to act.
Yes, yes. Amen. My God.
He said, wait on the Lord. Wait for what? What am I waiting on? For his goodness to be revealed. He said, be of good courage. He's going to strengthen your heart. And again, I say, wait on the Lord. Wait for what? Wait for his goodness to be revealed. Hallelujah to God. You've got to be able to see God's goodness. Because how many know you got to see it now? Because they're coming a greater revelation of his goodness. It is good that you're going through right now. You still didn't lose your mind. You didn't crack up. How many know it could be worse than what it is? It could be in worse shape than what it is. It could be a better, a worse situation than what it is. But I'm telling you, if you would maintain and have a right perspective of God, have a right mindset concerning God, you will see the goodness of the Lord. Listen, you're seeing it now. You already see it. But there shall be a greater revelation of the goodness of God. Sometimes we look back and say, you know what? I didn't know all this was going on. I didn't know all that was happening. Lord, I tell you, it looked bad, but you know what? You was good to me the whole time. Your goodness was there the whole time. I just didn't know it.
My God. Amen. My God.
Tell your neighbor, right perspective of God.
Right perspective of God.
So now I'm on the path to intimacy.
My God.
Look, listen, look what David. David's got the right perspective of God. Yes, sir. He's got the right perspective. Hallelujah to God. Now, even though he went astray, how many know he's getting on the right path now?
My God.
Make sure y'all understand. Here's David now. Hallelujah to God. He's got some momentum brewing now. Hallelujah to God. Not only is he keeping the word, and watch this, y'all. It's like a domino effect, y'all. Make sure y'all understand. It's like a domino effect. And because, hallelujah to God, because David has a right perspective of God, he's able, because first of all, because he kept the word, that now he's being taught the the word, he's getting a deeper revelation concerning the word, and a deeper revelation concerning the word means a deeper revelation concerning God. And so now you can see, hallelujah to God, now David, hallelujah, not only is he keeping the word, now he has a deeper revelation concerning his God. He said, man, you're good in nature, and not just in nature, but in action. He said, now look at verse 68. Now he's to the place, hallelujah, watch this, y'all. He's to the place now where he asks God to teach me. How many know he's become teachable now? He has a teachable spirit. Because make sure you understand, when he went astray, don't tell me that God wasn't pulling at him. Don't tell me that God wasn't, hallelujah, calling him to come higher. That God wasn't calling him to pray. Listen, come on here. We know that now. Hallelujah to God. When we go astray, we can hear God saying, don't go there. We can hear God saying, don't do that. We can hear God saying, don't touch that. We can hear God saying, pray. We can hear God saying, seek my faith. You can hear God saying, come to the altar. You can hear God say, how to get it deeper. You need to come deeper. You need to seek me deeper. You need to come higher. Don't tell me God wasn't talking to him. But somewhere down the line, now David had a teachable spirit. Hallelujah. He said, teach me. Man, that's a powerful testimony when you can tell God, teach me. Listen, you just went astray, David. But David said, yes. But now, hallelujah, I have a teachable spirit. Hallelujah. I want to. And if you look at that word, when he said, teach me thy precept, he said, I want to be a teacher. I want to be an expert. I want to be an instructor. And it also means, in the Hebrew, I want to really learn.
My God.
I want to really learn. And that word also means, listen, to learn, to be teachable, mean to be capable of being taught. It means to be spiritually active and willing to learn. I'm willing to learn. Hallelujah to God. I don't know it all, but I'm willing to learn. Hallelujah to God. Bible said, it is not the hearer of the law that is just before God, but it's the doer of the law that shall be justified. I want to have a teachable spirit. Hallelujah. How many know that? That's when you know you're getting close to God. You'll be intimate with God. But when you get to the place where nobody can tell you nothing about nothing and about nothing, and you know everything about everything and everything about nothing, hallelujah to God. I'm telling you, you can tell when somebody is intimate with God and has a close relationship with God, they have a teachable spirit. I'm telling you, even a baby can teach us something. Even a child can teach us something. They're willing to submit, hallelujah, not just to authority. Hallelujah. Sometimes folks, they over. Folks, that they over. Hallelujah. They're willing to submit to them. What you say, that sounds good. What you say sounds right. I'm going to try what you say. You know why? Because I have a teachable spirit. I'm not so high. I'm not so lifted up that I can't come down and learn.
Yes. Amen. My God.
So I've got a teachable spirit. The Bible said, blessed are they that hear the word of God and keep it. Hallelujah to God. Yes, sir. I've got a teachable spirit. The Bible said, whosoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken them to a wise man which built his house upon a rock. Watch this, because I've got a teachable spirit. The rains descended, the floods came, the winds blew and beat upon that house, and it didn't fall. You know why? Because it was founded upon a rock. When you have a teachable spirit, make sure you understand that you are founded upon a rock. When you have a teachable spirit, make sure you understand the rains may come, the floods may come, the winds may blow and beat upon your house. How many know, but your house won't go anywhere because you have a teachable spirit. You ever see somebody, hallelujah to God, get in trouble time after time after time? And listen, I don't want nobody to have this testimony about me. You can't tell them nothing. You can't tell them nothing. They're hardheaded. They know everything. What they're trying to tell you, you don't have a teachable spirit. And how many know, but the closer you get to God, how many of y'all know there comes a humbling, there's a humility of that, and you have a teachable spirit. Let me tell you something. Listen, I'm so glad. Let me tell you what my spirit is in. My spirit is in that I can be taught from people stuff I already know.
Let's go.
I don't stop folks. They could be telling me something and they really think they know something. And they say, man, is this, and if you go this, and if you do it like this, let me tell you what worked for me. And then when they get through telling me what worked for them, I knew that when I was 10. Yes. But when they get through telling me, you know what I tell them? I humbly listen to them and I say, thank you.
Yes.
Man, I appreciate that for sharing that with me.
Is that God.
That's a teachable spirit. Man, you cutting folks off for the year. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I already know that. Mm-hmm. You tell me that I don't already know.
My God.
He told me nothing. Hallelujah to God. Because you don't have a teachable spirit. Because if you listen closely to the detail, you may know everything about that situation. Mm-hmm. But you know what? I just learned something new.
Yes. And I didn't know that.
Hallelujah. Why? Because I have a teachable spirit. When you don't have a teachable spirit, can I tell you what's in your vocabulary? I know. Because you're not teachable.
Yes.
That's a sign you don't want nobody to tell anything. Hallelujah to God. Come on here. Because after a while, somebody going to have some valuable information for you. And they're not going to share it because you know.
Yes.
I ain't telling them nothing. They know it. Cut me off before I even get started. Is that all right?
Yes.
But I want to have a teachable spirit. Hallelujah to God. Pastor teaching on finance. I already got that together.
My God.
But yeah, but keep listening. There's something God's going to. God is so good. You may have all your finances together, God is so good. He's going to slide something in there just for you. And you said, man, that was for me.
Yes.
It may look like Pastor went over the same thing, but Lord, that was for me. Make sure you understand it is intimacy that will cause you to have a teachable spirit. He said, teach me thy statue. How many know your wife can teach you something? Your husband can teach you something.
Yes.
Your children can teach you something. Your parents can teach you something. You ain't grown and know everything. Your pastor can teach you something. Come on here. Ministers in your church can teach you something. Deacons, the ushers can teach you something. You've got to be in a position where, hallelujah, I'm teachable.
Yes. Amen. My God.
David said, I know I'm getting closer. He said, teach me your statutes. Yes, sir. I mean, no, David said, I'm open. Yes, sir. I'm open to be taught. Hallelujah to God. Watch this. And now he moves on to number 5. Hallelujah. I already told you what I need to know tonight, Pastor. Number 1, I went astray.
My God.
David went astray. What do I need to know, Pastor? That the path to intimacy starts. David said, I kept your word. What do I need to know, Pastor? Mm-hmm. Number 3, the path to intimacy is having that right perspective of God.
Number 4,
the path to intimacy is being teachable. Well, what's the next thing? Number 5, the path to intimacy is having correct focus.
Correct focus.
Yes, sir. You've got to have correct focus. Look what David said. He said, the proud have forged a lie against me, but I will keep thy precepts with my whole heart. Make sure I got to explain this to you, what's going on here. David said, listen, oh God, I praise you. How many know he has correct focus? A lot of times, listen, make sure you understand, they forged a lie. David, but they didn't just tell a lie. They didn't just tell a lie. There's a difference in somebody lied on you and forging a lie. To forge a lie means to smear and to plaster over. That's what the word forge means. To smear and to plaster over. Can I tell you what the Hebrew says? It means to patch lies, to patch together accusations and slanders and shreds and patches and hints and small patches of accusations and slander to all come together and produce a character assassination. Yeah, I heard that so-and-so said that about him, and so-and-so said that about him, and so-and-so, I talked to the girl from say she knew him 6 years ago, and just plastering a bunch of lies together and forming a bunch of stuff together. Hallelujah to God. And it's like putting a puzzle of lies together, and you just forging lies and going on innuendos, and hallelujah to God, stuff of no value. You just forge and lie. There's no truth into anything that you have. You just telling lies. Hallelujah to God.
But
intimacy teaches me to focus on what I can control.
It is intimacy.
Hallelujah to God. Watch this, y'all. It is intimacy. Even I'm not trying to refute the forged in the past of lies, but I've got a strong desire. You know how I'm going to show everybody that's a lie? I'm going to walk upright. Yeah, yeah. You know how I'm going to show everybody it's a lie? I'm going to keep walking and doing right everything that God has told me to do. I'm going to keep the precepts, and I'm going to walk with my whole heart, and I'm going to keep the precepts so, and I'm going to do it with my whole heart. The folks going to say, you know what? I believe they were lying on him. Yeah. Folks are going to testify for me. I don't have to knock down the lie. They're going to knock it down for me. You know what? Hallelujah to God. If it was the truth, I'm going to tell y'all something. I don't believe it.
My God.
All I see is God in her. All I see is somebody that's trying to keep the precepts. Only thing I see is somebody running after God. Only thing I see is somebody love the Lord. And they may go with you. They may be in it with you for a season. But after a while, they'll say, man, leave that man alone. You know that man love the Lord.
My God.
Cut that fool mess out.
My God.
I ain't with you on this. You need to get right.
Yes.
Yes. Come on here, tell you but look at, so what do we learn? What do we learn from intimacy in this verse? Correct focus.
My God.
He's focusing on Minister Avery on keeping the precepts. And he is so focused on keeping the precepts with his whole heart. He's not worried about forged lies. He's not worried about patchwork lies. He's not worried about his desire is so strong to do the will of God. He is walking, can't even, he's in an intimate place with God now. Yes, sir. He's striving toward that place of intimacy. The Bible said, I will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on thee. Hallelujah. What I see out of this verse is a man whose mind is stayed on the Lord. What I see in this verse, hallelujah to God, I see intimacy all over there. I see a man, he said, you're lying against me, but I'm keeping the precepts with my whole heart. I could be chasing down your lie. I could be, hallelujah to God, speaking evil against you, asking God to get you, and hallelujah, getting in the flesh and getting in a bunch of foolishness. He said, but no, that is not my aim. My aim is, hallelujah to God, my aim is to keep the precepts with my whole heart.
Yes.
Let me tell you something. Man, that brother Sanquan, it's not even a piece of my heart want revenge.
My God.
Because I'm going after them with my whole
heart. My God.
Heart. Yes, sir. Tell your neighbor, look at intimacy. Okay. Yes, sir. David, he's on the path to intimacy. It is correct focus. Quit focusing on the folks that did you wrong. Quit focusing on that. And you need to focus on keeping the precepts with your whole heart. Quit focusing about those that did you wrong, those that did you evil. I listen, hallelujah to God. I'm not going to make light of it. They did you wrong. They did you dirty. I'm not going to make light of it. But I want to tell you, keep the precept when you get to a place of intimacy. Your mind and your soul and your whole being is caught up in keeping the precepts.
My God. Amen. Oh, God.
I tell you, they were forged lies.
Forged lies.
I won't even dare. Tell you, they were forged lies.
Forged lies.
It is made up a lie.
My God.
Hallelujah to God. I remember one time, hallelujah to God, I had to go to Texas. I went to Texas. Hallelujah, the company sent me to Texas. Hallelujah to God. And somebody put a lie, I won't end no Texas.
Thank God.
They said that was a big lie.
Oh,
that I won't end in Texas. Hallelujah to God. I told my wife, I said, here's the plane ticket. Here's the, and I had to show her nothing. She knew better. Here's the bill from the motel. Oh. Hallelujah to God. Here's a picture that somebody painted on the streets of San Antonio,
my
Texas.
God.
Is that all right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir. Took a picture from the big sign and said, welcome to Texas.
My God.
They forged a lie.
Yes.
I hope they repented. They lied for no reason.
Yes.
There was no reason, no rhyme, no reason
my
for
God.
The lie. They
my
just
God.
Lied.
Yes.
I tell you, neighbor, I laughed at the lie. I ain't trying to run the damn lie. I know who lied on me. I ain't trying to call and say, why you lied on me?
Yes.
Hallelujah. You know why? Hallelujah to God. Because I was focused on keeping the precepts. Listen, we can't allow to get sidetracked. When you are intimate with God, you don't allow yourself to be sidetracked.
Yes.
You don't allow yourself to get caught up in mess. You don't allow yourself to get caught up in revenge. revenge and hallelujah, trying to get even. And yes. You killed my cat, but tell Lucky he better watch it tonight.
Oh God, my God.
Intimacy is correct focus. Hallelujah. He said that, hallelujah, that God, I keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is what? Is stayed on thee. I think I'm going to stop right here. I don't think I'm going to go any further. I don't think so. Anyway, he said, watch this. In Psalms 123:2, said, behold, as the eyes of the servant look to the hand of their master, and the eyes of the maiden to the hands of their mistress, so our eyes wait upon the Lord our God until he have mercy upon us. We've got to have focused eyes, just like the servants look to their master, and just like the maiden look to their mistresses. We have got to be so focused. We are so focused and single-eyed that we are looking to the Lord. How many know that's a sign, man? Hallelujah to God. That's a good sign. That's a sign that you're getting to a place of intimacy because you are being focused. And that's why the Bible said in Joshua, he told Joshua, he said, one thing I want you to do, Joshua, is I want you, hallelujah to God, I want you to be focused. He said, watch this. He said, there should not be a man be able to stand before you all the days of your life. The same way I was with Moses, I will be with thee. I will not fail thee nor forsake thee. But this is what I need you to do. He said, I need you to be focused, be strong and of good courage, for unto this people shall that divide for an inheritance the land which I swear unto their fathers to give them. But only be strong and very courageous, that you may have observed to do according to all the law which Moses my servant commanded thee. Watch, this is where focus come in at. Turn not from it to the right hand or to the left, that you may prosper wherever you go. Stay focused. Don't allow nobody to turn you from the right or turn you to the left. Don't you allow no trial, no tribulation, no lie, nothing from your past, nothing present, nothing to come to turn you from the right or turn you to the left. He said that you may prosper wherever you go. And he said, listen, and furthermore, this book of the law shall not depart out of their mouth, but you meditate therein. He's trying to tell him, listen, he tells him, don't lose your focus. And then he tells him how not to lose his focus. He said, don't let this book of the law depart out of your mouth, but you meditate therein day and night, that you may have observed to do what? To do according to what is written therein. It is then you're going to make your way prosper. It is then you're going to have good success. He's trying to tell us the same thing that David was saying. I will keep thy precepts my whole heart.
Yes.
Tell you, they were the same thing.
Same thing.
Joshua 1:8, same thing. It's basically saying the same thing. It is intimacy.
My God.
It causes us to be focused. We've got to be focused.
Yes.
My last verse I want to talk about, focus. One of my favorite verses. One thing. David knows about focus. We in Psalms 119. He told us in Psalms 27. David understands that I'm getting to a place of intimacy.
My God.
Hallelujah. Because David knows about intimacy. Because in Psalms 27, he said one thing. Have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, to inquire in his temple. David loved God so much, he said one thing, but God is so good, he ended up naming three.
My God.
He said, one thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after. You said one thing, David, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. That's just one thing. But David goes on to say, and while I'm there, I want to behold the beauty of the Lord.
My God.
Oh, hold on. And by the way, I want to inquire in his temple. He was so intimate with God. He was focused on the spiritual things of God.
Oh, God.
Focus.
Focus.
He said, I'm not worried about trouble.
My God. Focused.
Tell you that, but David was focused.
David was focused.
You know why? Because he was intimate. And David said, in the time of trouble, I'm not worried about trouble, Brother St. Juan. You know why? Because he's going to hide.
Yes.
In his pavilion and in the secret of his tabernacle, he shall hide me and he shall set me upon a rock. He said, my head is going to be lifted up above my enemies round about me. David is bragging on the Lord because he is focused.
Yes.
It is intimacy leads us to a road of focus.
Yes.
Let me do a review and we get out of here. Let me do a review. Well, Pastor, what did you tell us the night about intimacy? I wanted you to know that David went astray. That's one. Second thing, I wanted you to know the path to intimacy starts with us keeping the word. Keeping the pastor, how do I get back where I was? Keep the word.
My God.
The next thing is you got to have a right perspective of God. David said, thou art good and you doest good. You're good in nature and you're good in action. And then David had a teachable spirit. He said, teach me thy statutes. And then, hallelujah, David had focus. He said, the proud have forged a lie against me, but I will keep thy precepts with my whole heart. He's focused on keeping the precepts. He's not tracking down lies. Mm-hmm. He's not going to the right. He's not going to the left. But David is focused on the goodness of the Lord. He is keeping himself in perfect peace because his mind is stayed on thee because he's trusting in the Lord. I hope and pray something I said tonight was a blessing to you. I hope and pray that this teaching, the simple teaching, listen, if you're looking for something extra deep from me, you're not going to get it. Hallelujah to God. You're not going to get it. But I'm going to give you the simple, unadulterated word of the Lord. Hallelujah. Something that you can take and go back and really feast on it and receive from the word or receive what God is saying unto us tonight. And remember, God is calling all of us to a place of intimacy. He's calling us. And I know some of us may have, everybody had went astray, but some of us may have went astray.
God
is calling us back to a place. Listen, we may have left our first love, but how many know our first love is still there?
Still
waiting on us and calling us to come back to me. Hallelujah to God. God, I praise you for it. I love you for it.
Thank you, Father.
Listen, we gotta go. But listen, we'll be back Sunday morning at 8 o'clock, and we'll be praying at 8 o'clock. And then on Sunday morning, we'll be worshiping the Lord at 11 o'clock on Sunday morning. But listen, we got to go. But remember this. Share this with somebody. Like it. Comment. I see a lot of y'all that get comments, but you won't like it. Get comments. Like it.
Let's go.
Share it. And tell our many viewers that when you at least let us know you're there.
My God.
Hallelujah. Don't tell me we got that many views. Hallelujah to God, and we're not a blessing to somebody.
My God.
Don't be ashamed to say Pastor Fleetwood, you was a blessing to me. Don't be ashamed to say, Pastor Fleetwood, I watch you tonight. Pastor Joyce, to thank God. Hey, hi. God. Love you. Something. Don't be ashamed. Hallelujah to God to do that. Is that all right? God, I praise you. Listen, I gotta go. But somebody asked the question, is there any word from the Lord? And I want you to know that yes, there is a word from the Lord. I tell you what, also, by way of TV, you can watch us Sunday morning at 7:30 on hometowntv8.com. hometowntv8.com. From 7:30 to 8 o'clock. You can watch us on Channel 8 also if you're in the Marion, the Dillon, the Roland viewing area. You can watch us on Spectrum on Channel 1311. Channel 1311 from 7:30 to 8. And if you don't have that cable network, you can just find us on Hometown TV 8 from 7:30 to 8 o'clock on Sunday morning. And then Sunday night from 8 p.m. to 8:30. Then on Monday morning from 8 a.m. to 8:30. And be blessed of the Lord. Somebody asked the question, is there any word from the Lord? And I want you to know that yes, there is a word from the Lord. Be blessed, my friend.